Good morning, guten Morgen, buongiorno. Welcome to our Greentech Festival Conference 2022. My name is Jennifer Sarah Boone, and I am super honored and excited to be leading through today's conference. And if I could go back to the 10, 11-year-old me who founded an environmental club fishing rubbish out of the river and not really knowing what to do with it, and told her that I'd be leading through a conference that aims to create a better and greener future, she would be so proud. We have an incredible lineup of change drivers, sustainability advocates, and brave visionaries to take a close look at how we can create a better world in which sustainability is synonymous with success. One thing is clear, those who stand for inclusive, sustainable, and ethical values will be rewarded by investors, by customers, and by the market. We have a celebrity surprise for you, and of course, you will have the opportunity to network and exchange ideas. So let's start the conversation now and be open for great possibilities for positive change. And of course, you can't have a grand opening without the brilliant minds behind the Greentech Festival. So please give it up for Greentech Festival CEO Judith Kühn-Gerres and Head of Conference Dale Rickert.
Good morning, everyone.
Judith, Dale, what's it like to be having to organize an event with real people again at such a large scale?
I mean, it's amazing. We have been lucky because we had also the last 2 years people live attending, but not 10,000 than today. And it's the first time that the hangar is event location. And I think especially my team did an incredible job. So thank you them.
100%. And today at the conference, it's all about content, which brings me to you, Dale, as head of conference. Are there any sessions or speaker highlights that you are looking forward to?
Yeah, thanks so much, Jennifer. You know, it's actually really hard for me. Over the 6 months preparing for this event, I get to know so many of the speakers that are coming on stage personally. So it's hard to pick out one favorite. But after last night, I have to say one person has really won my heart. And that's little Venetia, the winner for the youth prize yesterday. And she's giving our opening keynote today. And we're really thrilled to have her.
Absolutely. What about you, Judith?
So I'm really excited about the CEO pledges that we have the first time at the Greentech Festival. It will be 10 top CEOs from Europe and around the world that give their pledge to the climate change. And I'm really happy that we will also have one CEO live on stage.
Perfect. Well, I'd say a huge applause for the teams that put up this monumental program. Thank you so much. Great job. And hopefully, you will be able to enjoy some of the content.
A little bit, I guess.
Thanks
so
very much.
So enjoy, have fun.
Thank you very much. This year, the Greentech Festival has partnered with Italy as their official partner country. And this means if you were at the awards yesterday, or if you browse through the exhibition, and even at the driving experience, you will get a little taste of Italy. And to tell you more about what that means, it's my pleasure to invite the director from the Italian Trade Association to the stage. Welcome, Francesco Alfonsi.
Hello, good morning everybody. Thanks for being today here with us. Very proud to be as Italian Trade Commissioner here representing my country, Italy, partner land of this event, of this edition of Greentech Festival. I invite you to visit our stand, our pavilion, where we show the Italian commitment in research and science to find the perfect balance with the nature. Nature doesn't produce rubbish. Nature recycles everything. A perfect balance with nature, following the rhythm of nature, could be the solution to save our planet. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Francesco Alfonsi. With the help of technology, the Greentech Festival aims to transform business practices so they can drive sustainable change. And to win the fight against climate change, we need to make sure that our actions align with our efforts on a global scale. The United Nations Framework Convention on Climate Change is key in unifying these actions. As part of the Greentech Festival's newly forged collaboration with the United Nations, it is our pleasure to bring you a call for action from Patricia Espinosa, Global Head and Executive Secretary of the UNFCCC.
Dear colleagues, just as the co-founder of Greentech, Nico Rosberg, drove hard to take the checkered flag during his racing career, the world must work with the same intensity in our collective race against climate change. We know our goal. We must stabilize global temperature rise at 1.5 degrees by the end of this century. Yet, we seem to be a driver whose car is out of control. Currently, we're on pace to more than double that number. At risk is more than a trophy or a reputation. Remaining at our current pace will have disastrous consequences for humanity. In fact, it threatens the health and longevity of humanity on this planet. Just as it took a team for Nico to win, it will require the ultimate team effort for humanity to address climate change. Not just a team consisting of governments alone. It's going to take all nations, all business sectors, and every single person working to boost climate action if we're to achieve the 1.5 degree mark. At UN Climate Change, we are proud of our work with all actors to drive climate action. And we have a name for it, inclusive multilateralism. We work with the sports sector, the fashion and food sector, and many others to specifically support their work and provide guidance as they strive to boost climate action and achieve carbon neutrality. And through our Race to Zero and Race to Resilience programs, we are rallying leadership and support from businesses, cities, regions, investors, and others for a healthy, resilient, zero-carbon recovery, one that prevents future threats, creates decent jobs, and unlocks inclusive, sustainable growth. Technology is an incredibly important part of all this work and is a key component of the Paris Agreement as well. I want you to know we value your work, you, the entrepreneurs and technology experts, and we fully appreciate how critical your work is to achieve our collective climate goals. Friends, I know we live in challenging times, yet climate change is not an agenda we can afford to push back on our global schedule. That's why, if we are to ultimately achieve our 1.5 degree climate goal, we cannot make plans for 2050 alone. We must make this a decade of action. We need plans, we need innovation, we need technology, and we need it now and in all sectors, government and none. Not someday, not eventually, now. Firm plans within the next year or two. As I told delegates at the recent climate change conference in Bonn, I appeal to all of you, especially in these difficult and challenging times, not to lose hope, not to lose focus, but but to use our united efforts against climate change as the ultimate act of unity. Climate change is a race. We can come out stronger. And with your help and the help of Greentech, we can make enormous progress together. Thank you so much for your efforts.
A digital thank you at this point to Patricia Espinoza. Next, we will bring you the story of a fascinating and very determined young lady from the rural town of Tiruvannamalai in Tamil Nadu, southern India. Vinisha Umashankar was just 15 years old when she became fed up with the pollution caused by coal-fired ironing rickshaws in her local town. So she decided to invent her very own sustainable alternative. She recently placed in the global top three of the Earthshot Prize run by Prince William and Dr. David Attenborough. And yesterday, she won the Green Award in the category Youngster. And we are absolutely thrilled that she will be leading our opening keynote for the Greentech Festival. A huge applause for Vinisha Umashankar.
Thank you so much, everyone. Change. It's eternal. It's the only thing that remains constant in this world, which is often having one thing or the other thrown at us. It occurs every day, minute, and second. And these changes, whether they seem good or bad at the time, will definitely teach you something new. And through these changes, you become more flexible and understanding as a person. And it also prepares you for the future. Our future, however, seems to have a different plan in mind. It's the change of our future, climate change. I'm Vinisha Umashankar. I'm a 15-year-old student, innovator, and public speaker. You could call me the jack of all trades, master of some, as I have several interests ranging from science, arts, music, and technology. Getting back to the point, thank you. Climate change is not something that can be battled by just one person or one country. It's a global problem which requires a global effort. Several countries coming together to tackle this issue, which is one of the most pressing issues of the century. And for now, we can say that events like the Greentech Festival are bringing together several exceptional individuals together. And together, I'm sure, by the end of this festival, we would have raised several more connections and several more ideas, which is a better step towards a cleaner future. And all these results can become a reality with the help of people with fresh perspectives. I'm talking about the youth. And this decade has honestly been a decade of opportunity for the youth. We've been raising our voices all across the globe and bringing our ideas to light, which hasn't been quite possible in the early 2000s as such. But now times have changed, and as a result, I'm here on the stage today, for which I'm very grateful. And speaking of opportunity, how did I get my opportunity? I'll take you on a bit of a story back into the days when I started working on my innovation. So my whole journey towards the solar ironing cart started when I was 12 years old. And at the time, innovation was not really the thing on my mind. So I would say I just wanted to find a solution to a problem. And what exactly was that problem? So all of you here are familiar with an electric iron box. However, that is not really the case in India, where I come from. Though India is developing, and we often see electric iron boxes, where I live, it's a rural town. And there, charcoal is being used to iron our clothes. And there is a problem with charcoal. It causes air pollution, deforestation, respiratory diseases, and all of these contribute to climate change. I saw this problem, and I'll just tell you exactly how the problem works. So metal is a conductor of heat, and the cast iron box is made of metal. So charcoal is put inside it, and the heat produced by the charcoal is used to iron clothes. Now, we iron our clothes every single day, and so do the people in India. So when you use this system of ironing, you burn almost 50 million kilograms of charcoal every single day in the country. And just imagine how much damage that does. Though it may seem like a problem that is only localized to India, it contributes to a much bigger global problem. And for that, we have to start local. And that's how I did it. I started with an innovation, a solution that could help prevent a local problem. And that helps climate change and global warming in turn. So that's how the journey started. And after a few years, I managed to prototype and patent my product, which was also a really good thing. And coming back to the point, all of this started just because I had an idea to change an aspect of my locality for the better, an idea that could use a sustainable energy instead of a harmful one, like charcoal. And today, we are using much more sustainable resources than before. Just think about it. In the 18th century or in the 1800s, when the Industrial Revolution was going on, charcoal was an amazing source of energy. It was something like people had never seen before. It could be used to run steam engines. It could be used for almost anything imaginable. But times have changed and they've evolved. This is one thing we should all keep in mind. Something that has been used in the past, it doesn't always mean that it is suited for the present or the future. So our sources of energy and the way we use it should also evolve as time goes by. And that is one thing we should be keeping in mind, because though charcoal was good in the past, it is no longer good. And here's another thought for you all. We are using renewable source of energy. We are capable of harnessing energy from the elements of nature. If that doesn't make you feel powerful, I do not know what could. We can harness energy from the sun, the wind, water, and even Earth itself. If we are having such amazing sources of energy, why do we still depend on sources which are harmful to the planet which we live in? That should not be the case, and which is really glad that times are changing now, with innovation and much more coming up. And just look around of the exhibitions around here. Several people have come up with ideas that are much better than before. Existing products, but made much more sustainable, which is what today is all about, using our energy for good, because we are capable of amazing feats of intellect. So why should we use that to harm our Earth instead of protecting it? That's one question that I've asked myself several times, over and over again. And I've come to the conclusion that we all should be protecting our planet, and regardless of which race or which country we belong to, and even regardless of generation, because it is true, at this moment, in the present, all kinds of people are living on this planet, and not just people, other organisms, animals, plants, microorganisms, they're all forms of life with only one planet to depend on, to live in. And we cannot keep harming the only planet we know to support life. As of now, there is no plan B. And keeping that in mind, we should also remember another thing: our target for net zero by 2030, 2050, or 2070, you name it. But if we are to achieve those goals in such a short span of time, then imagine the amount of effort we need to put in. Though it may seem completely overwhelming, I think saving a whole planet, that is an amazing thing that we should be doing. If we could possibly harm it in such a short span of time, surely we can save it as well. And just a final thing, the Greentech Festival is aptly named as a festival because we should be celebrating our planet, not just on Earth Day, but every single day, because our planet is something to be cherished. And I hope all of you will remember that today. Together, we can definitely change. Thank you.
Thank you, Vinisha. Can you stay with me for a moment?
Yes, definitely.
First of all, congratulations once again for the Youngster Award yesterday.
Thank you.
What are the next steps for you now after being here and inspiring all of us today?
Yes, so for now, the solar ironing cart is currently a business model, and I'm working with a team to bring it to the market, so hopefully it will be out by the end of this year or the starting of the next. So that will be my next step for now.
What do you feel do businesses have to keep in mind to maybe attract young talents like you?
I think most of us youngsters, we often yearn for honesty when it comes to sustainability, because to be really honest right now, there are several businesses which claim to be sustainable but are actually not. So when you want to attract young people towards your business and you claim that it is sustainable, we also want a part in it, and we want to make a big change, because the world in the future will be ours, and we want to make sure that it is a safe planet to live in.
Do you feel that there are already opportunities where businesses can speak with young talents, can speak with academia, can speak with individuals?
Yes, definitely. And the Greentech Festival is one such example right now. And there have been several more platforms actually coming up across the world with the same initiatives. And that's really good, because over the past few years, the numbers have increased exponentially. And I think that's a really good sign that more and more people are starting to understand and the urgency related to climate change.
And is there like a community of the next generation that all the brilliant minds come together and exchange ideas?
Yes, definitely. I think we are starting to connect with more and more youngsters around the world. And through events like this, we meet even more of them. So I think hopefully, maybe one day in the future, we will have an event where there are several youngsters around and just putting forward their ideas. I think that would be an amazing thing.
Absolutely. Do you have any other projects planned right now, or are you focusing on the rickshaw?
Well, I am focusing on the solar ironing cart, but that does not mean I'm not having any other ideas planned up. I have about 5 to 6 of them, which are also focused on sustainability and affordability, because not only do I want to help save the environment, but also the people who live in it. There are several of them who need more affordable and sustainable products, because I've seen that in the market, sometimes it can be really expensive to purchase products which are made sustainable. So I'm trying to bridge that gap right now.
That sounds very good. Have you had the opportunity to browse through the exhibition? Was there anything that caught your eye?
Yes, I did have an opportunity yesterday, and I must say, Spot the Robot is a really fun thing to look at, and also the amount of vehicles over here, the automobiles, that is something I really enjoyed looking at, because I also work, the solar ironing cart is a mobile vehicle, and just seeing several more of them out here, it did make me really happy yesterday.
So you said it made you happy yesterday. You also experienced the awards yesterday. You had the possibility to browse through the exhibition. Would you say overall that you are hopeful when you look into the future?
Most definitely. Just seeing how much awareness has improved over the past few years, it's really amazing, because just a few years ago, going back to my school, nobody would exactly know what climate change was, though they had a vague idea about it. But now everyone knows exactly what it is, at least where I live. And the solar ironing cart, it's not only helping me, but several other people to gain awareness about it. And I think that is something really amazing over the past few years.
Well, thank you once again for being here today and to share your inspiring story with us. I'm sure you will have the opportunity to have way more conversations today. Thank you very much, Vinisha.
Thank you.
And at this point, I would like to ask Dale Rickert back to the stage to chat a little bit about our upcoming panel. Okay, I just heard that we're going to continue with another program. I promised you at the beginning that we have a celebrity surprise for you. And you can't really have an opening ceremony without a celebrity. So we have something very special in store for you today. The young lady you're about to hear from has been at the top of the charts across the globe, and she responded personally to a call from Nico Rosberg to lend her voice to our movement. She's known for her authentic and passionate approach and efforts to fight climate change. The one and only Billie Eilish.
Hello to everyone at the Greentech Festival. This is Billie. As you all know, we have to do a better job of taking care of our planet and our people, and we have to do a better job of taking care of one another. Events like this are so important for sharing our resources, information, and passion for a topic that is so vitally urgent. Thank you so much for being here.